Good morning, students of class 11. Myself, Sanjay Kumar Tiwari, your English language and literature teacher, is now ready to take you to business letter in which I made you aware yesterday what are the important points of format of in which I made you aware of the components of business letter. Dear students, I am going to just make you aware of each and every individual components, how to write, what are the points you have to keep in your mind, and what just precautions you have to take when you are writing a business letter. Students, the first letter that you have to write, if it is business letter, the first thing that you have to keep in mind, the heading. In heading, you have to write the writer's or company's address, phone number, email or fax, and the date below the address. Thereafter, you have to write the date. So here you would like to understand, you have to understand that in the heading, no name, no father's name, no any others' names are written, only writers or company's address, phone number, email or fax, they are only written. One example has been given here, 120 Lajpat Nagar, Amritsar, and thereafter the date, 2nd March 2017 or whatever date is there. So, one thing you have to keep in mind is that there should be a little bit gap in between the heading and the date so that the difference may be understood. The second point is that you have to express your greetings. Dear sir, madam, dear Mr. Sharma, Mrs. Sharma, etc. It is written just below the date line where the address of your receivers is written. Examples have been given here. So you have to make it very forceful, very polite in manner. And thereafter, the third point is that you have to write the subject. The subject is the central bearer of your letter. It is heart of the letter. So it should be written in very concise manner, in very short manner. And it is generally used to give the meaning of your letter, what is the aim of writing the letter, for which the letter is being written. It should be underlined if you want to make it better. It means subject should be underlined because it should be understood or identified without any delay. Thereafter comes the main body. The main body of letter contains the message. As I have stated, it is generally divided into three phases. First one is the general introduction, and third one, the aim of writing the letter, what is the reason for which you are going to write the letter, and just third one is that if you have any suggestion, any appeal, you have to write. Students, here I would like to make it clear that you have to write the main body according to the point, the fact that is there, and you should avoid just hikey-eyed expressions. It means your expression should be real, it should be short and catchy sentences because it adds to the beauty of your letter. As far as possible, be friendly and polite. You should not be impolite. All the thoughts should be well organized and interlinked. Interlinked means the facts should be related to each other and they should be just arranged properly. Those who omit this important part of the letter are given 0 marks. It means you have to describe the main body in very clear cut manner because this part makes you able to get good and accurate marks. So this body should be expressed and written clearly and very nicely. The fifth point is that the subscription. Here you are told, don't close the letter abruptly. the following expressions needs to be used. For strangers, yours truly. For business person, yours faithfully or sincerely. Students, here you are told not to use yours instead of yours. It means very important point. I am going to make it clear that this expression is not correct. This expression yours is written like that. No, this extra sign is used because it is already in possessive manner or possessive case. If we use dear madam, sir, we use yours faithfully as the subscription. But if the we use dear Mr. Ravi, the use yours sincerely as subscription. The sixth point is that your signature. Sign your first name, write your name after the subscriptions. It should be written in formal way. It should not be written fully in capital letter. Capital letters are not allowed. The first letter may be capital, but all the letters of your signature, if written in capital letter, may not add glory to your beauty, and it will just give a chance to the evaluators to cut the marks. Last one is the seventh point, where enclosures. If a business letter is accompanied by some other papers, a mention should be made of these enclosures in the line below the signature. First write enclosure in short or in full form, and then 1, 2, 3, whatever enclosures, whatever additional papers, whatever some other papers you have to add in order to make your letter forceful and meaningful, so write here. And it is generally written after signature in left side, and it should not be written in right side. So students, this is complete explanation of the components of a business letter. Now I am going to take you to one solved example where you will be in position to understand it clearly. So this explanation, I think, makes you aware just where you are in position to write your letter. There may be business letter in form of inquiry, letters of inquiry. There is a sample paper, it is AK Electronics, and the person whom this letter is written is the manager of the same company, and the person one who is writing is Raman Kapoor. He wants the following products manufactured by the company. The first one is AC stabilizer, second one emergency tube lights, and the third one digital inverters, domestic and commercial. After that, the writer of the letter has made it clear, kindly furnish the details about the following: the best rate, trade discount, a special discount, mode of transportation, and at last subscription is there. He has written, I am looking forward to your reply soon, and thereafter, yours faithfully, Raman Kapoor, manager. So this is a solved letter of inquiry which comes under letter of business. So go through it and try to understand it. In next video, we shall come to know about the other kinds of letters. Thank you.